Apple is about to announce the new version of iOS, and that is iOS 16 in a couple of months. And I know every device that will support iOS 16 and new feature expectation from this new iOS version. Do you want to know them all? Then watch this video till the end. Hello everyone, I'm Nikhil from iGeeks blog, and today in this video, let's talk about the iOS 16 supported devices and their new features. Every time you guys ask me questions like, will iPhone 7, 6S, 6S Plus, iPhone SE first generation support iOS 16 or not? Let me answer to all your questions, and let me first talk about the iOS 16 supported devices. The first on the list is rumored iPhone 14 series will surely support iOS 16. The next is iPhone 13 series will support iOS 16. Also, iPhone 12 series and iPhone 11 series will have support for iOS 16. iPhone XS, XS Max, iPhone X and iPhone XR are on the list too. And iPhone 8 and iPhone 8 Plus will also support iOS 16. Now the real question comes, will iPhone 7, 6S, 6S Plus or iPhone SE support iOS 16 or not? The answer is yes and no. Who knows? Actually, I know. iPhone 7 and 7 Plus will support iOS 16. However, iPhone 6S, 6S Plus and iPhone SE first generation will drop support for iOS 16. There is a reason behind, like iPhone 6S, 6S Plus and iPhone SE first generation has Apple A9 dual core CPU, and it is expected that iOS 16 will house this new feature will require more powerful CPU to perform actions. So sorry my fellows, if you are having iPhone 6S, 6S Plus or a first generation of iPhone SE, then your device will not get support for iOS 16. Now let's talk about the iPadOS 16 supported iPads. Every iPad Pro model like 10.5, 11, 12.9 inches which is launched in 2016 or newer will support iPadOS 16. iPad Air 3, iPad Air 4, iPad 6, iPad 7, iPad 8, iPad Mini 5 and iPad Mini 6 will also have support for iPadOS 16. And with that, let's talk about the very first feature expectation from iOS 16, and that is most used application folder. In iOS 15, Siri always suggests our most used app in a different ways, like with the help of widgets and while we jump to the spotlight search. And with iOS 16, it will add a folder of our most used app and that we can place it to the dock or on an iPhone home screen. The next feature will offer more customization option in iOS 16 and that too on home screen. On the iPhone lock screen, Apple placed two buttons, one for a flashlight and another to quickly access the camera app. However, there are few more apps that we require to access quickly, just like these two. There is no option to customize lock screen in iOS 16, but with iOS 16, we can expect that Apple will allow customizing these two buttons. Next on the list is Quick Notes on iPhone. With iPadOS 15 and macOS Monterey, Apple has introduced this very useful feature of Quick Note. Sadly, it is not available on iOS 15, but I am expecting this feature with iOS 16. After Quick Notes, one more feature we want in iOS 16, and that is to show battery percentage. Apple has shrunk the notch on iPhone 13. However, even after having more room to place something, Apple didn't edit the battery percentage. It is expected that Apple will rearrange the position of battery icon and will show the battery percentage next to it. And the last one is redesigned app icons. Apple releases the design changes that we don't notice. If we compare the design of the first iPhone OS to iOS 8 or iOS 11 or the latest iOS 15, then we can clearly see a huge difference in the design. However, we didn't notice them just because Apple released them gradually and will continue to do that for our better experience. In iOS 16, we can expect a new set of app icons for a couple of apps and not for all the apps. And that's it. This is the list of iOS 16 supported devices and few feature expectations from new iOS 16. But the question is, when Apple will announce the iOS 16? So I already know the answer, and that is in the WWDC event that is about to happen in June 2022. So stay tuned with us, like with iGeeks blog, to know every update about the new iOS 16. And for that, you need to subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn on all the notifications so you never miss such great update from us. And with that, like this video and share this video with your family and friends. Along with that, download our all new iGeeks blog app to enjoy exclusive content about everything Apple. Now allow me to say goodbye. I am Nikhil signing off. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay connected.